It's showtime.
Okay. Hey, welcome to Did You Watch Survivor Last Night? This is the only fun Survivor podcast. My name is Jake Scheidel. Each week I ask my best friend, Thomas Powell, if you did indeed watch a certain reality show. And I say each week, but we did actually, for the first time in 9 years, take 1 week off last week. So we have to cover two episodes this week. Anyway, Thomas, how's it going today?
It's good, Jake. It's 4:20. It's the weed day today.
And just yesterday, buddy.
Damn it, I missed it. Oh, now God, I can't smoke weed for another year.
You can't smoke weed for another 364 days.
Damn it. I was so sure. I was so excited about it. I bought a shirt with a bunch of pot leaves on it.
That's good.
Also, I think I'm the first millennial to use the word pot in a very long time. Nobody. It's a very boomer way to talk about it. But
are you guys smoking pot this weekend? Yeah, buddy.
You guys, yeah. I was watching. I was at a like birthday thing for someone yesterday, and they had some MLS games on, and I was like, everyone should have. Because, you know, they'll have, like, special holiday jerseys for certain stuff, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, they should have, if you play on 420, they should have, like, weed-themed jerseys.
Or even maybe
just, like, the refs wear shirts that have, like, weed leaves on them. Wouldn't that be great? I think we can do that.
What if instead of, like, the black and white ref jerseys, they're green and white instead?
I love that, yeah. I think it's time that we all celebrate what is, I think, eventually going to become America's, like, most prestigious holiday.
Absolutely. I think that, I know the NBA season is in the playoffs now, but I do think that they should play special games, specifically the Milwaukee Bucks and the Boston Celtics. Are there any other green teams?
OKC's kind of green.
I thought OKC was blue and orange.
They're like a teal color almost.
Oh, like the Pistons.
Yeah, kind of.
Okay, so I found thepaperframer.com, and it has all of the colors listed. Wow, red, blue, and white, and yellow are very popular colors for the NBA, I'm finding out.
Oh, Dallas. Dallas also has green jerseys.
Okay. Well, a lot of teams have green jerseys, but their team color is not necessarily green. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Dallas's color is green, though.
Dallas's color is green. According to thePaperFramer.com/teamcolors.php?type=NBA, the Dallas Mavericks are dark blue, black, and silver.
Okay. Well, yeah, I guess they... Maybe I'm thinking of their old jerseys because they do wear like a newer version of those sometimes.
Yeah, they're.
I don't like this. Can you say the name of that site one more time?
Thepaperframer.com.
Yeah, slash.
I deleted the time already. I wish you hadn't asked me that question.
Well, I've got a bone to pick with the paper. I think thepaperframer.com sounds like thepedantframer.com because.
Yeah, that's a good one. It is thepaperframer.com/teamcolors.php?type=NBA. Chicago
Everyone
Bulls, red, black, and white.
If you also want to follow along with what team colors are what?
Detroit Pistons, red, blue, and white. It's America's team. I looked up green NBA jerseys and I got a ton. And I was like, this is too many. I don't need every team's 420 jersey. I just need to know which colors are green. So I said, NBA green teams. And it just showed me the Golden State Warriors. And I was like, no. And then it showed me Draymond Green's Wikipedia. I said, no, this is not what I need. Although he did play for a green team as well, did he not? The Michigan State Spartans.
For the damn Michigan State Spartans. Yeah, I like that you basically, you'd search something and you got like the same experience that you get when you're on like a streaming service where you just get like 100 choices that aren't what you want.
Yeah.
Like, no, I don't want this.
I love streaming. My favorite thing to stream is a little show called Survivor. Thomas, did you watch Survivor 46 last night? Saw some spill, I don't do bummy. Cause I saw my shots in town, the neighbors
think that I'm Andrew Murray. Now all this food in my tummy. This is the rare instance where I can say that I actually watched it twice.
Yes.
There were two episodes that we watched.
I've been waiting all week for you to say that.
I didn't think it would be as annoying this time because it's actually two episodes.
It's accurate, yeah. First episode we watched this week was called Episode Several. Remember? Do you remember Jelinski?
Jelinski is legend.
Jelinski, may he rest in power.
Since Jelinski flamed out super quickly, I think that I have a weird fondness for him now. I think I'm going to remember him for a while as just like a weird guy that was on Survivor. So you know what? Good for him.
I think that's everybody's reaction to him, honestly, including Jeff and the rest of the cast.
He seems nice.
Yeah, he seems like a
really chill
guy.
Everyone seems to remember him fondly.
I could absolutely see him coming back and again being voted out first.
It'd be great. I'm open to it.
I would love to see that happen. So we get the Nui Nui tribe. I think that's how it's pronounced. I haven't heard anybody say it out loud yet. Venus is sad to see her name written down and accuses Soda of being the one to do it, but Soda denies it. Soda and Venus, huh?
You know, Venus is a real mastermind. She sees everything that's going on, and she influences every decision in the game, and definitely isn't having like a Mr. Magoo-like run over these last couple episodes.
I can't believe you compare Venus Vafa, the hottest person of all time, to Mr. Magoo, the notoriously ugliest person of all time.
Yeah, an uggo like Mr. Magoo.
Then Charlie tells Venus it was actually him who voted for her. Why did he do this? This was stupid. Is he stupid?
I don't know why you would tell. Like, the last thing that you want to do is tell Venus anything, really.
Big
Although,
episode.
I don't know, then she'll get really mad about you not telling her anything. So I don't think you can win in any situation with Venus. I think she's going to get moody and mad at you no matter what.
Doesn't mean I'm not going to try, you know? I think this was a big couple episodes for Maria and Charlie, which makes a lot of sense given the holiday this weekend. Because they're from the Green Tribe also.
It's true. I think Maria is kind of in pole position after these last two episodes. I think that she has the best chance to win of anybody in the game.
Yeah, I think Maria looks great after these couple episodes. Obviously, Q is pissed about what Charlie did. Ben wakes up having a panic attack. Oh, we don't need to talk about Q right now. Let's just move on.
There's going to be a lot of stuff to talk about with Q. He had some high highs and some low lows over these two episodes.
Indeed. Ben wakes up having a panic attack. Liz and especially Kenzie help him through it. Good couple episodes for Kenzie also.
Yes. No, Kenzie is also doing great. I'm very in on Kenzie.
Kenzie is on the upward trajectory, and I feel like I'm kind of rooting for her. I know we've had so much judgment. We're so judgy of everybody in the pre-merge. And then as soon as the merge happens, like, oh, I actually like this person.
You know what it is, though? It's that they, like, I think they start being as influenced by production, or they stop being as influenced by production. Like, I think the early episodes, everybody's getting prompted. They're still sticking to the, like, original script of, you know, their bio videos and stuff like that. Like, I'm sure you've noticed that Charlie isn't talking about Taylor Swift as much anymore. Mm. They've moved on from that.
Did mention it once.
Yeah, and it's amazing, like, how much less annoying everybody gets as the show goes along. And, you know, the stakes and gameplay kind of get upped.
You say they're sticking to the script in the pre-merge, but Thomas, would you believe that this show is actually unscripted?
Yeah, they were actually, what they were doing was they were starting being real.
Yeah, it's actually all improv. I would love to go to a live finale if they ever did those again, and like raise my hand and be like, yeah, I'd like to know how much of this show is improvised, like during the Q&A segment. Like, it's just so dramatic. There's no way that you guys all came up with it yourselves, but sometimes it's so funny. Like the Taylor Swift and Metallica thing. Where did you come up with that? Anyway, I'm still mad about that like 6 weeks later. At the Immunity Challenge, they have to stand on a pyramid over the water, but there are two winners, you know, because we're merged now, so there have to be two winners. The winners get Danishes
and two eliminations because we're merged. And
right.
We have to do small group eliminations, which are good every time.
Nowhere to hide.
They're always what you want.
There's very calm waters, so we get a flashback to last time they did this challenge when the waters were more chaotic. It's pretty boring, so Q decides to start the alphabet game, but nobody follows the rules. I really enjoyed this punchline from Charlie when he's like, okay, Q, I've got it figured out. Baltimore.
Yeah, that was good. At that point, it was unsalvageable, so it was good that he got a fun joke in there.
Yeah, and then he did do the Jim Halpert into the camera. I do feel like Charlie is leaning a little too much on that this season, but whatever. You know, we love a good bit. Okay. Tim then asks Jeff, what's up? And Q explains to him that he's asking how long they've been up there, and it's very funny. Tim then gives shout-outs to everybody in his family and everybody else's, and Q makes fun of him. And then Tim says, shut up.
Wasn't Jeff asking Q about something? Q is like, my daddy said that if you're not in a fight, keep your mouth shut.
Yeah.
And when Q was talking about something later, Tim was like, didn't your daddy say if you're not in the fight, keep your mouth shut? And I love Q just goes, you right.
Yeah, that was very funny. Kenzie wins immunity. Maria also wins immunity and the reward of Danishes and whatnot. Pretty exciting stuff. The losers go to the old weed camp, the Sega tribe camp. I think in this situation, the people who go back to the losers camp should get that camp's buffs for that round only. Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah, it'd be fun to bring them back.
Bring it back. We have to go back to the Sega camp.
It'd be great if they also had, like, you win one candy bar that has to be divided evenly among all of you.
I do love when they do that. That's so funny. At the reward, or I guess on the winner's speech, Charlie is the assumed vote, but Tevin has other plans. I wonder what that means. That's all I wrote.
Good question.
At the loser's beach, Q has yet to show his ability, and that's actually by design, to see if his alliance is really strong. Q's motivations are so odd to me.
It's big swings. I think he is just such a huge control freak that I think that's one of the reasons he's abandoned plans, because, like, the second that it's not 100% his plan, he immediately gets pissed off. So yeah, it's one of those things where, like, I think that he does have some really good instincts, but he jumps to conclusions way too quickly.
Yeah. Tim immediately turns on Hunter because he is the only Nami on this beach, even though he's part of the six. Did Tim forget how alliances work as soon as it was necessary?
See, this was the one instance where, because I was like, well, obviously you can't target anybody in the six, but, like, if you're going to target somebody in the six, it should be the person that immediately was like, we got to get one of our own members out from this alliance we just formed. It's like, okay, well, you're not trustworthy, so we're going to get you out.
Yeah. Q, though, plans to vote for Ben so he can stay loyal to the six. I've heard people say you're not supposed to put numbers in alliances because it tells people how many people are in your alliance. But I do think it's very funny that their alliance name is literally just a number.
Yeah, I like the six. It sounds like a bad horror movie or something.
Yeah, well, they're all killed off one by one. Oh my God.
Yeah.
And then they have to, like, bring in another friend to their friend group, just like in Survivor 46. Survivor 40 the six.
Yeah, Survivor 40 the six. They're all getting eliminated from, they're all getting voted off Final Destination style right now.
Yeah, exactly. I would watch it. Everybody wants to nap except for Charlie on the winner's beach. And Soda says Charlie in a British accent a la Charlie bit my finger. Were you excited?
Yeah, well, how old is that video now? That's a very old reference.
It's got to be at least 15 years, maybe more.
There was a 30 Rock joke about, like, Jenna, when Jenna was hanging out with her, like, new crew of people, one of them was Charlie Bit My Finger. And it was, like, supposedly an older version of that kid.
This was
also Mankind was one of the people she was hanging years out ago. With.
So that's 13 years old, and that was actually a video of a soda after the tribal council.
How old? Yeah, is the kid from Charlie Bit My Finger old enough to play Survivor now?
I think the older kid probably is, because that video was 13 years old, and he was I don't know between 5 and 8. I can't tell how old kids are.
Get that guy on Survivor. Yeah, it's time.
What's Charlie's brother's name? Hashtag get Charlie's brother on Survivor.
Well, everyone talks about Charlie, but nobody asks how the other kid who's bitten, who's probably traumatized, is doing.
This is victim erasure.
Everyone asks who his brother is and not how his brother is.
Mm-hmm. Soda targets Venus, but Tevin is nervous about Soda and targets her. Man, this Nami is bringing the drama. Nami, more like Drami. Does that work?
There's just a lot of bottled up stuff because they've never had to go to tribal before.
Yeah, it's great.
So, like, it's all coming out.
Venus tries to target Tevin, but nobody is hearing it. Damn. Hmm. Nobody ever wants to listen to Venus, even though she's always right. Isn't that interesting?
I love that Venus frequently throughout this is like, Tevin is just, like, keeps targeting me for no reason at all. And then every single time that any strategy thing comes up, she's like, we should get Tevin out.
That's a good idea, Venus. Maria explains to Venus how she's off-putting. This was nice, I guess.
She's right. Like, this is 100% correct. Venus does not know how to approach people. She just comes in at like 110% every time. And is anytime that you are like, I don't know, I got to think about it, she's like, oh, so you don't want to do it then?
Wow. Everybody hates strong, passionate women. I see.
Yeah. I did like that Maria was like, look, I was 20 years old once. I've been there, done that. I was like, yep, that is 100%.
She's actually 25, so joke's on Maria, actually. At the Losers Camp, the Toronto International Film Festival targets Ben over Tim. I would have loved to see this. I don't really care either way between the two of them.
Nah, I wanted Tim out. I want Ben in the game.
Yeah.
Tim has a fatal flaw as a player, whereas Ben, I think, is like, I think Ben is playing a really good game. So.
Well, yeah, we're going to see about his gameplay here in a minute. Hunter is adopted by the Yanu 3, and he is apprehensive and willing to play his idol if necessary. Great episode for Hunter, too.
Hunter's awesome.
Yeah.
I love that guy. He's great.
He didn't really do a lot, but he didn't need to do a lot either. So.
No, he's one of those guys that, like, is, I think, good at not making himself too visible.
Yeah.
Although I think he needs to stop showing off in challenges. I think that's probably a bad idea to keep doing that.
Mm.
But yeah, like, I think he's playing a very good, subtle game.
Yeah, I think so. And he's holding on to that idol. That's pretty good. Q tells Ben he might be on the chopping block, and he says, what do they say on Survivor? No risk, no reward. Do they say that?
I don't think they say that on Survivor, but it sounds like something that people might say on Survivor. Yeah, so.
It's an idiom I've heard before. Q is indecisive, making Kenzie and the Toronto International Film Festival nervous. I'd be nervous, too, if Q was my ally.
He's tough. It is tough to be in an alliance with him because he has to be in control and he will just flip things without telling you.
Yeah. We'll talk plenty more about Q in next episode. But at this first tribal council this week, we see Hunter saying he is happy to work with the Yanu 3. I thought Hunter played this tribal very well.
He knew exactly who to put himself with.
Yeah. Made his intentions clear and was, you know, straightforward with it. which you can't say about everybody on this season. Tim says this tribal is about who's a threat. Yeah, man, they all are. Ben talks about...
This tribal... Dude, the Nami resentment from him was so weird. Like, he was so mad that one Sega tribe member got voted off that he was like, you guys think you're so great, huh? Like, literally to Hunter was like, you guys think you're hot shit, huh? Well, guess what? You aren't.
Yeah.
It was like, you're at the merge now. What are you doing?
Ben talks about his panic attack and Kenzie helping him and calls himself an entertainment monkey at a party. Huh. Why do you say that?
I get what he was going at, where he's like, he's like a guy that people like to have around, but not really like get to know, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Like people, you know, it's like people like find you entertaining to be somewhere, but they don't actually care that much about you as a person. So he was like, it was nice to make some real connections with people.
Yeah, that's nice. Feeling for Ben, for sure. Jeff compares the Yanu 3's choice to Sophie's choice in terms of humans, he said. This was an odd comparison,
Sophie's choice,
right?
Was also a choice of humans.
I'll admit I've never actually watched Sophie's Choice, but I do know what it's about.
Yep.
And it felt like in poor taste to make that comparison, Jeff, but like if it were a blood versus water season, I could understand making that comparison. Felt weird for this, but whatever.
You're going to get on This Is Why You Suck if you're not careful, Jake.
They don't even
be careful here.
Oh, Thomas, they don't even do This Is Why You Suck anymore.
What?
They haven't done This Is Why You Suck all season, and that is why Jeff sucks.
Yeah. That's unacceptable, Jeff. Come on, do better.
Him removing This Is Why You Suck is why he sucks. That's all I'm saying. Tim has
proven it definitively.
But he actually loves to be mocked. So
he does. He's his favorite thing. And all of the recap podcasts are good.
That's what I heard. Yeah. Hunter gets 2 votes. Tim gets 4 votes and is voted out. All right, fine. You know, I don't think I'm going to miss him. We didn't really get much.
No,
from
I
him.
Liked Tim just fine, but he wasn't like gameplay wise. He wasn't really adding that much. The only thing he would ever pop up for gameplay was when he would get very paranoid about big alliances that didn't really exist.
Yeah, like the biggest alliance was one that he created or was helped in the creation of. And then he destroyed it immediately. It's just a weird choice. But what did Jeff say at the beginning of the season? The theme of this season is don't trust anybody, Tim included.
I guess you can't, because like he was the first thing that he really did of significance on the game was get really paranoid about a women's alliance that didn't happen because it never happens.
I was gonna say, and, do you think his wife and grandma are gonna make fun of him when he goes home?
You gotta believe that'll happen. But then he was like, while they already had a big alliance, was like, well, Nami will have numbers, and it's like it's the post merge. Like, what are you doing?
If you were aware,
you can't
at
be
all,
with your tribe forever, dude.
Like, you have more people with you in the 6 than you do with your weed tribe, my guy.
And if that's a concern for you, then you don't say it to the person that wasn't in your tribe. Like, that's the thing. Why would you tell Q that? Q's not a Sega. He's a damn.
The other one.
What's the third one?
Yanu.
Yanu, he's a damn Yondu from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh, yeah, of course. I can't believe we forgot about him. All right, at this second tribal council, Jeff asks some question. Liv gives some non-answer that I did not pay attention to. Do you remember what she said here?
No, I don't.
Moving on, Charlie talks about being the obvious target. Maria talks about nobody coming to vote for her or talk to her. Then they vote. Soda gets 4 votes. Venus gets 2 votes. You know, good move. Happy to see it wasn't Venus.
I don't understand. Venus is, I will be so happy when she's out.
Guess we'll never be happy again.
She's your Angelina this season. She's absolutely, she has the exact same ceiling as Angelina, which is like third place and a historically bad showing at Final Tribal.
What I'm hearing is all she needs is a 10-foot ladder. The second episode this week, the most recent one, was called Hide and Seek. Fine title. Whatever. Who cares?
Yeah, it's no episode several, but it's hard to follow that.
Yeah. Episode 8th roll. Because it's happening in an 8th roll. April.
Okay. Episode April and the D. That was funny to me.
At camp, Ben is sad that Tim is gone. Q needs to always be moving. He's like a shark, he says.
I did think it was funny. I was kind of with Q on this one where they were like, all right, do we want to talk about it? Let's go talk about it. And they went down to the beach and then everyone just sat there fucking around instead of talking about it like they were said they were going to. It's like, are we going to talk about this or not?
Q does not want to be on a vibe season. Q wants to be on, I don't know, a hard gameplay season. What's a season where everybody was playing really hard? 42? 43? This one is...
Whatever the all-winner season was.
The Winners at War?
Winners at War, yeah.
Look, they all want to play on Winners at War, but only 20 of them can. That's 40 now. I guess 40... How many winners have there been? There have been 45 seasons of Survivor. Two people have won twice. What is that? 45 minus two? 43. There have been 43
winners.
One person
has won three times.
What? Who?
Oh, no. Yeah, sorry. Two people have won twice. Yeah.
It's like, I don't think that's right. Okay, so everybody is shocked to see that Venus is still around, and she tells everybody what happened at Tribal, throwing Tevin under the bus. Great move by Venus. Great move by Venus. Tevin thinks
yeah,
it's
all of the,
very
all of the
funny
great
how Venus
work that Venus was definitely doing off camera. Like either the production hates Venus more than any player in history, or she's not actually doing anything.
No, I think it's the first. I think she is.
No one has ever been treated more unfairly than Venus has
like
by
she's
production.
Never done anything wrong. And
just because she's so gorgeous.
Just
I
because
can't,
she's
she can't
pretty
help it if
and
they're jealous
and
of
passionate.
Her.
Like, sorry, folks. I don't know what to tell you. Tevin thinks it's so funny that Venus is taking credit. But now Liz wants to take credit for the soda vote because she has such a big ego.
I do like that everybody is accusing everyone else on the tribe of copying each other. Like, Hunter was really the only thing holding that tribe together.
Honestly, like, do you guys not understand that you need more than one vote to get somebody out in most cases? Like, you all had to work together to make this happen. It doesn't happen without all of you. But it's the 46th season. How do you not realize this by now? What did you think of Q's Q-skirt?
I thought it was a fun segment. You know, it reminded me of the like morning show thing from whatever the fourth season is.
The ultimate vibe season, Marquesas.
Yeah. It definitely like it was fun because it seemed like they were having fun. I don't think it was like the funniest thing in the world, but like I like when they get further into a season and it's like, well, we got to keep ourselves entertained. So yeah. This is what we're doing.
I thought it was fun as well. I do think, though, that it should have, instead of being called the Q skirt, be called the skirt, but spelled with a Q instead of a K.
I do like that, yeah.
And I also think that anytime Q is involved in any word, any situation that involves a word starting with K or C or anything, we should replace it with a Q. I don't really know how that translates to an audio podcast, but it's something I'm going to be thinking about, you know?
We'll be monitoring the situation.
Like, Q spells the six S-I-Q-S, like Cisco. The six, oh. Okay, whatever. You know, who cares? Charlie is keeping an eye on Q, but staying on his good side. Charlie's playing a good game, we all know this. Q invites Charlie to the Six, who is replacing Tim in the Six, I guess. This is Final Destination, Friends Edition.
Now, I really liked Charlie, the talking head, with him being like, if you're on Survivor, get up around sunrise. That's where all the big conversations happen. Mm-hmm. Like,
I liked when one of his talking heads, when Charlie said, something always goes awry in these groups of Six. Am I what goes awry? Pretty good line. It also
rhymes. I like it. Charlie making a good end of season push. I've been enjoying his game.
Yep, he is ascending as well. In my opinion, Q starts a game of hide and seek in order to see who can hide in plain sight the best.
This was fun, but this also was like a lot of this was staged for production. Like you could tell.
No, what are you talking about?
Like you're like Hunter at the very end where they're like, where is he?
Okay, so Charlie is it. Venus is seeing people's personality traits through this. That was fine. Q.
This was a great jumping to conclusions segment because it was like her and Q just being like, this proves that this person needs to get voted out right now because they're good at hide and seek and that's dangerous. And it's yeah. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? But if we're talking about how people revealed themselves, I think that this actually was the most sort of like perfect distillation of Venus as a player because Venus did a good job of recognizing what other people were doing and also got caught first because she's not good at, she has no self-awareness.
Are you saying that Venus made a big mistake?
Yeah, she made a big mistake getting caught.
Q thinks Liz made a mistake by going into the woods to find him.
Yeah, because she does care. She can say that she doesn't, but it's like, yeah, of course she cares. She's still on the show.
They can't find Hunter and Ben, so Q just announces the game will end in 60 seconds. Q, you're not in. I don't think you're allowed to make the rules once you elect Charlie to be it.
Yeah, come on, man. Whatever. He's got to be in charge.
Of course. Q says Ben made a mistake by being too hard to find, and Hunter also made a mistake by climbing a tree.
Everyone is making mistakes.
Like, this definitely...
This was a test to see if you would try to be good, to try to win the game that we were playing. If you try to win the game, that's a mistake.
What you were saying about it feeling so production heavy, like this so obviously was just like the producer asking Q, what mistake did this person make in hide and seek?
The first cut to Hunter in the tree fucking killed me in this though. This segment was worth it just for him like peering out of the tree.
Yeah.
But yeah, at the end when they come back to the shelter and he's in the tree above it and everyone is like, where's Hunter? Where is he? Like, that was... They had seen him at that point. They just wanted to have that.
Yeah, it's like playing hide-and-seek with a toddler. It's like, oh, I don't know where you could possibly be. As they're hiding behind, like, a playground staircase that has holes in it.
Yeah, like 10% of their body is covered up by, like, a tree that they're hiding behind.
As Q says, if I can't find you in hide-and-seek, I can't find you in the game. For sure, my guy, for sure. Venus and Tevin have a debrief. Tevin tells her that he's playing moment to moment, which makes Venus nervous because that's what Soda was doing, remember?
Yeah, Tevin's hanging by a moment here with you.
Liz is annoyed with Tevin for taking credit and targets him. This is what always happens. Stop taking credit for things before the fucking tribal council, the final one. That's what it's called.
This is a thing where, like, I think Tevin did play a very good game, but it's like you have to be careful about who you're talking to sometimes.
Mm-hmm. I liked this, like, I think the only scene from Ben this episode when he's just sitting in the water and goes, man, this game's really intense, but sometimes you just got to pause for 3 minutes. And he just, like, looks out over the ocean and no one acknowledges him. Yeah, for sure, guy.
That was, by the way, there. If you want a reason to like Ben, there was a tweet that I saw that was somebody being like, why has no one gone on Survivor and just referenced the, like, treated it like it's Lost and just referenced all the Lost stuff?
That's what we're doing. And,
yeah, I know. Well, and then he responded to that person and was like, it didn't make the cut, but that was me. And I was like, ooh, Ben, fellow Lost head.
Okay. That's convinced me. I like Ben now. Ben from Survivor, not Ben from Lost. I know they tried to hit that redemption arc, but he did still kill off my favorite character. With one of my other favorite characters.
If you called him Henry Gale, he'd probably like it.
Yeah. You could call Ben Regale. That's so stupid.
Sure, yeah. Okay. Yeah, we do that.
Tiff is over targeting Venus because she has become a non-factor. I agree with Tiff, and I think that's how Venus is going to make it to the end and win the whole game.
I really want, I would really like Venus to come to the end and just give the most delusional, like, I actually controlled every move.
Yeah.
To, like, the one of the most hostile juries to her of all time.
Yeah. I think she's going to do a great job, and she's actually going to win the whole game. Tiff is keeping her eye on Maria, which, according to Q, is a big mistake.
You have fucked up. Every episode, there's like four moments where he's like, you have fucked up.
Yeah. Fuck around and find out is Q's entire strategy. Q tells Maria that Tiff has an idol, so they target her. I hope Q never leaves this game. He is so much fun to watch.
Well, you know, he might threaten to leave a few more times, but... yeah, it seems like he always manages to pull back from it.
I think it's so, like, I never know what's gonna happen next with him, and it's always fun.
At a certain point, though, like, he's too active a player, and he's too erratic that, like, I just don't think you can trust him as an ally.
Yeah.
At a certain point, I think people are just gonna, he's gonna become a big liability, and I think people are gonna have to get him out.
Yeah, it'll be interesting if it's next episode, or if the Yanu 3 keep him around and try to rein him in every week. But after a while, like, that's got to be exhausting.
He'll start making moves. Like, he already gave up that Tiff has an idol.
Yeah, he did.
As part of, like, an aborted move where it's just, like, you can't have somebody like that that sort of goes into business for themselves without you present. Even if you're able to turn him back to your side, like, he's going to give away information that is vital like that. So, like, yeah, I just don't think he's trustworthy.
Yeah, 100%. Speaking of people only being in it for themselves, Jeff offers them rice at this immunity challenge, but they don't take it at this rice negotiation. First time ever in the new era.
Did anyone even volunteer to do it?
I think they got up to two or three people. But no, they didn't get there.
That's crazy.
I think it's great. I wish more people would do that. However they cast this season, they need to do again, because it's just some of the most selfish people I've ever seen.
Yeah, everybody is playing for themselves. That's why these alliances, like, everybody's worried about alliances, but they don't come into play because no one will stick to them.
And honestly, that's why I think Venus and Hunter are both in really good spots, because, like, nobody's really aligned with them anymore. So they can just bounce around and be all right, because nobody's going to want to align with them for too long. This is the classic challenge where they have to hang on to a pole for as long as possible. We all love this challenge. It's a classic. Jeff included.
We got two in a row that are, like, classic. Just, like, balance on a thing in the water and hang on pole.
Yeah.
They're always good.
I like this one more than the floating in the water thing. I think it was just issue of the weather that day, but whatever. Generally, I think that's a fun challenge too. What did you see, the cool slow-mo shot of Charlie putting his teeth on the pole and then Hunter mean mugging him near the end of the challenge?
Yes.
Pretty cool, right?
Yeah, sure.
Like, we've really got to fill these 90 minutes.
They were on there for a long time, okay?
Yeah, we get it. Charlie asks Jeff for rice as he's about to drop out. Very funny moment between Jeff and Charlie. Did you notice this, or are you playing a video game at that time?
I might have been playing a video game.
Damn. You missed a great bit. Hunter does a cool upside down bend after he wins. Did you see that?
I did see that, mm-hmm. And I was like, dude, you gotta not, like, if you're gonna win every challenge, you need to not show off while you're doing it. People are gonna start targeting you.
You love the golden boy, but the golden boy loves to show off. Q is pissed off about the challenge and not getting rice when they get back to camp. They're still planning for the Tiff blindside, but Liz wants to take out Tevin. You know, I talk a lot of shit about Liz, but I do think this was a good move from her.
Oh, yeah, for sure. She got out a stronger player. I do kind of wonder, because her whole thing is just being, like, completely under the radar. It just doesn't seem like she's super involved. And maybe that's just an edit thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I think people need to be careful with her because if she keeps kind of picking people off, she's going to be able to, like, I don't know that you can take her as a goat. I think she's going to have too much of a resume.
Yeah. Well, you know, she's sold all those businesses and runs all those other ones. That resume's got to be pretty impressive. Now I really want to look at her LinkedIn. Not right now, though. I'll do it on my own time. Q is annoyed the plan has changed again. Maria tells Charlie about Tiff's idol. Oops. Bad news. Bad news for Tiff. What was I just going to say? It was something about Q. Oh, Liz. Never mind. What I really want to say at this point is it's time for wildlife shots. We got quite a few because we did two episodes this week. We got Roland the Bat, say what's up to our Thomas's son, Roland.
He's my boy. I love him. Okay.
Then we got some gulls. I did really like the quick zoom in on the goshawk, however you pronounce that one, when they did Hard and Seek. As the game is called.
Yeah, I also enjoyed that.
We also got a shark. We got the red-footed booby. Thomas, we've talked about boobies all the time.
We're always talking about boobies on this.
We're always talking about boobies on this show. Where can they be found?
They can be found in Fiji.
That's accurate. They can be found in tropical parts of the oceans. Their plumage varies, but what color are their feet?
Probably red, I would think.
Correct. From how high will they dive into the ocean to catch their food?
I'll say 50 feet in the air.
Try like half as hard.
25 feet in the air.
13 to 26 feet. What are they hunted by? And how?
Are they hunted by larger birds, maybe?
No, you're thinking of the wrong environment. Not sky.
Are they hunted by crabs? Do crabs get them?
Coconut crabs, to be specific. Do you know what the crabs will do?
Oh, yeah, the most fucked up crab.
Mm-hmm. Do you know how they hunt them? What they'll do to them?
I'm assuming that just, like, large groups go after them.
They will take their big claws and break the wings. That seems intentional, right? Like,
yeah.
Why do they breed on remote islands, the red-footed booby?
I don't know. Do they not like humans?
I mean, I guess that could be part of it, but more specifically to avoid predation. And because of that, where do they rank on the IUCN red list?
I'm going to say least concern.
And you would be correct. Okay, let's talk about this tribal council. Jeff says, we got to start with the rice negotiation. Do we? Nobody went for it.
I was just bad-mouthing Angelina, but if she was there, things wouldn't have gone down that way.
Exactly. And then Jeff asks, is the rice negotiation indicative of where the game is? Stop. Nobody cares about this.
I think the rice negotiation says a lot about the economy. And
Survivor really is about the economy. Just... Oh, God. Do you remember when the new era started and Jeff almost had a shop that was staffed by Rick Devins to buy advantages?
Ew.
Yeah, we almost got something real bad. As much shit as we talk about the new era, it could have been a lot worse.
Bring back fire tokens. If we needed a real economy, bring back fire tokens.
Bring back fire tokens, bring back the medallion of power.
I always hear fire tokens in Natalie's voice, specifically.
Which Natalie?
You know, the one that won Blood versus Water. Wasn't she on that season?
Yes. Oh, and then we get to the most fucked up thing Q's ever done. Fucked up spelled F-U-Q-Q-E-D. Q asks everybody to vote for him because he feels responsible for something. I don't even.
Yeah, this is the second time that he's done this.
What was this?
I don't know. Everyone was very confused. Everyone was as confused about this on the show as we were.
I watched this once just for fun, you know, no taking notes. This is my new strategy when watching Survivor. And then I watched it a second time to take notes, thinking, oh, this time I'll certainly understand Q's motivation. Still nothing. I still don't understand what he was going for. Why was he feeling responsible for, what, the plan going wrong?
Yeah, I don't know. I part of me wonders if it, like, he felt like the plan was slipping away from his control, and he was like, well, I don't even want to do it then. I'm going to take my ball and go home.
I was on his side. I was on Tevin's side. Tevin supports Q's wishes. Hey, if he wants to go, let him go.
This seems self-evident to me, right? If somebody is, like, is escorting themselves off the show, let them do it.
Go ahead,
like, let them make a mistake.
I don't want to deal with this in 3 weeks, so go ahead now. I'll figure out a new plan. Like, what was it Kenzie saying? Like, you might be part of my plans in 4 to 5 tribal councils. Where does that leave me or anybody else who's making plans with you? And what Jeff
always
says,
well, I think they're taking a 3 strikes policy. If he tries to quit a third time, then they're going to let him do
it. Well, according to Jelinski, this should be his 3rd strike because supposedly Q suggested they quit first and they just didn't put it on the show because
at a certain point, you just need to let him do it. Like,
yeah,
call his bluff.
Q stands for quit for a reason. Then we get a live tribal. Charlie tells Tiff that Q told him and Maria about the idol. And Hunter just shakes his head and says, this is the dumbest thing ever. Hunter rules, continues to rule. I agree with him on everything.
Yeah. We love Hunter.
Yeah. Venus gets 2 votes. Tevin gets 8 votes. Very sad to see because
I was so bummed about this.
I really was hoping for Tevin and Venus to come together eventually and work together. So
that was never, that was absolutely never going to happen.
But Thomas, we could have had the Tevinus Alliance and that would have been great.
He apparently in his exit interview, he said like getting Soda out was a big mistake.
Yeah.
Cause he was going to need her going forward. He should have gotten Venus then.
Planned too hard, too fast, too early. Okay, so at this point in the merge, everybody's voting at 100% correct, except for 2 people. Do you know who they are?
So Charlie.
Incorrect. Charlie's been correct every time.
Oh, no, that was before the merge that he voted for Venus, yeah. Is it just the people that got eliminated?
No, they're not, I don't consider them anymore. They've been eliminated.
Okay, yeah, they're not real to you anymore now that they're off the game.
Exactly.
So it was, I'm trying to think of, did Liz vote for Venus that first time?
Liz voted for, who did Liz vote for? Oh, shit. In the last tribal council?
Yes.
Or in the first tribal council of whatever the fuck it's called, the merge. She voted for, she voted correctly, I should say.
Okay.
I'm trying to pull up the voting right now, but it's taking forever. Everybody has voted correctly every time, which is 2 at this point, except for Ben and Hunter. They've only voted correctly the one time.
Well, yeah, I should have immediately thought of Hunter, because of course he wasn't going to vote for Tevin.
Yeah.
I get why he wouldn't play his idol there, but I kind of wished that he had played his idol for Tevin there.
It would have been really cool.
To preserve the Andy Griffith Alliance.
Yeah, that would have been great. But I understand why he didn't. He needs that for himself moving forward. You know, it's still early in the game, even though it feels like it's been going on forever.
Yeah, if he goes on like a big run. I did like one of the things Key said this episode when Tim was saying, like, we got to get Hunter out because he's such a big physical threat. He's like, nobody wins 10 immunities. Like, you don't need to worry about this. Yeah. It's like, I think he's right. I think in general with like really physical players, like you'll get a shot at them.
Yeah. That's why he needs that idol, though. Okay, so last week, I guess last episode, you had 23 points. I had 19. So it's still a pretty close game. You got a point for the Toronto International Film Festival, making it through last episode, and another one for the week before. And I got 2 points for Venus Vafa surviving both.
I still can't believe that you picked Venus. This is just...
Why wouldn't I? She's the best.
I mean, I guess they only need to make it to Final Tribal, so you're actually not in a bad spot with her right now, because she might be the GOAT.
She also, not even Final Tribal, just the finale. We pick the Final 5 or 4, whatever it happens to be, for the finale,
right.
So...
You are right.
It's only a few more episodes, and I think she could make it. You also got a point for Hunter winning immunity. You got a point for Tim being voted out. You got a point for Soda being voted out. You almost got a point for somebody saying my baby to Charlie, but they said Charlie in a British accent.
In a baby voice.
In a British baby voice.
Yeah, this is a big week for me.
Yeah, a really good week for you. You got 5 points, up to 28 now. I got 2 points from our love, Venus Vafa, 21 points for now for me.
We're at a football score right now, 28-21, all touchdowns.
Indeed. Or a college basketball game in the first half. Okay, so you're sticking with Tiff, I'm sticking with Venus, obviously. Great couple episodes for both of them. Who's winning this next reward challenge?
I'll say Q wins reward.
Good call. He actually intentionally loses challenges, though, to prove his team's loyalty or whatever.
So that he has to grind harder.
Yeah, exactly. I will say Ben goes on the reward. What will the reward be?
We just had coffee and pastries. Mm-hmm. A lot of pastries this season. Mm-hmm.
We love a pastry.
Still no, I don't think we've had pizza yet, so I'm going to say pizza.
Sticking with the pizza. I will say chicken. Oh my God, they haven't even been to what is it called? The sanctuary where good things happen.
Where good things happen, yeah.
I think the reward will be they go to the sanctuary where good things happen. Who's winning immunity?
I'm going to stick with Hunter.
Yeah, that's fair. I will say, you know what, let's go with TIFF, the Toronto International Film Festival. And who is getting voted out?
Tough. I'm going to say Q. I'm going to say this is the episode where Q,
I know,
is deemed too much of a liability.
It feels like the obvious choice, right? But I think they're going to try to squeeze one more tribal out of him, and I think Liz will be the next to go.
That was the other person I was thinking of, so yeah, I could definitely see that.
Q makes the move on Liz or something, and then Q goes next week. Or the week after Liz, I mean. I could see that happening.
Well, I mean, if you remember, Liz did mess up because she went into the forest.
Right.
While playing hide and seek. So.
Big mistake.
Big, big mistake.
Okay, who do you think... Who is your final three at this point? We've got Charlie, Kenzie, Liz, Maria, Q, Tiff, Venus, Ben, and Hunter.
It's tough because I'm not 100%. I think right now, gun to my head, I would say Maria, Charlie, Venus is.
That makes sense.
And I
to
think
me.
It's the classic, like, number one and two in an alliance duke it out kind of thing. Yeah. And I think Maria wins.
I could definitely see that. I was going to say Kenzie, Ben, and Venus. Kenzie winning, Venus taking second, Ben taking third.
I could see that.
He's just happy to be there, you know? Like that.
I think Ben would have a real shot in that scenario, though. If Ben makes it to the final three, I think he has a real shot. People really like him.
People really like him, but it doesn't feel like he's playing the game as much as a lot of other people are. The way Charlie or Kenzie or Tiff are.
I think
Venus
he'd be able to make
even.
A good argument for himself, too. But yeah. It would be I mean, like, Kenzie is a really, like, Kenzie's played a really good game. So, like, it would be tough to beat her.
Yeah. Kenzie, I think if they don't get her out before the finale, I could definitely see her winning.
I think the one thing with Kenzie is, like, it's going to, with her and Tiff, it's going to come down to which one pulls the trigger first, because, like, I think Tiff knows that she's going to have to cut her loose at some point.
Yeah, I am not surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if Tiff played her idol to get out Kenzie, or if Tiff played her idol to keep Kenzie, you know? We'll have to stick around and see. Thomas, we had a couple big holidays this weekend. Can you tell us the week's quotes quiz?
It's so nasty that it's probably somewhat of a travesty having me. Then he told the people you could call me your majesty.
Which spring holiday best matches your personality? Spring is in the air, and with it comes a bouquet of holidays, from joining a trash cleanup on Earth Day to pulling pranks on April Fool's Day. There's something for everyone. Also, 420, I added that part.
Nice. This is from Jealous Hero 70, community contributor with only 360 points. What's with all these little tiny points that everybody's getting these weeks, these days, these weeks? What am I talking about?
Yeah, gotta step your game up.
Okay, what's your idea of the perfect spring day? Exploring nature trails and parks. Hosting a festive gathering with family and friends. Thinking of ways to make people laugh. Taking on new adventure or challenge.
One of those, all of those seem like things that you would do on a day, and one of them is just... thinking of ways to make people laugh.
Not making people laugh, which is what's happening in the photo they provided. It's like two people drinking coffee out in...
You can do that on any day.
Yeah. So they look like they're in fall. Everybody else looks like they're in spring. I'm picking nature parks and trails.
I'm picking hosting a festive gathering with friends and family.
Oh, you don't want to think of ways to make people laugh?
I'm thinking about that all the time. It doesn't need to be a perfect spring day for that.
Yeah. Pick a springtime activity, planting a garden, crafting colorful DIYs, spending time outdoors with friends and family, okay? Finally, getting back into pickup games in the park. Ooh. I do love the idea of playing basketball in the park.
That is pretty fun, but also it's pickup games, so I'm a little out of shape for that. Yeah. So I'm going spending time outdoors with friends and family, because I'm already doing that by hosting that festive gathering.
Exactly. I'm going to plant a garden. I've been really into plants recently. What's your favorite thing about the arrival of spring? Longer days and warmer weather, blossoming flowers and trees, baby animals, the start of baseball season.
Oh, man, there's a lot of good choices here. Yeah, everybody These are all spring. Good choices.
Ooh.
I'm going to say the blossoming of flowers and trees. A lot of good flowering trees. This past weekend when I was in Chicago, that one stretch of Logan Square that has all the flowering trees on the main drag there. Very nice.
Yeah. I'm going to say longer days and warmer weather. You know, I got that sad, you know, that thing that makes you sad in the winter. It's my favorite disorder because it's the most appropriately named.
It's true. Yeah. It tells you everything you need to know just by the acronym. I was just thinking when I got up to go to work the other day and it was like broad daylight out when I went out to my car, I was like, a month ago it was dark out when I would do this. This is great.
Yeah, it was like 7:30 last night and I looked out the window and it was still pretty nice out. Ooh, how nice. Can you get this next one, Thomas?
Select your favorite color scheme. Blue, red, and white. I don't know why they put it in that order. When there's an American flag there. If you didn't want people to think of the American flag, we shouldn't have put a picture of the American flag up there. Anyway, pastel pink, yellow, and lavender. Cute. Green and light brown, bright pink, red, and orange.
Ooh. That's a lot of energy coming from that last one. I feel like I know what my answer is going to be already, or my result, I should say, but I'm going to still go with green and light brown.
This is tough. I don't love any of these.
Thomas hates colors. Thomas hates America.
I do. I'll go green and light brown. No. I don't love that though.
Okay, whatever. You're going to have to convince yourself to love one of these, but I guess you could just steal mine. Choose a word that best describes your personality. Competitive, mischievous, joyful, nurturing. Oh boy.
I'm competitive about specific things, but I'm very competitive about specific things. Yeah. So I'm going to say competitive.
When my parents were in town, my dad was saying that I'm less competitive than my siblings, except for certain things. And then we played Carcassonne or Ticket to Ride, and I got extremely competitive. And it's like, oh, I didn't know I had that in me.
That came out of me when we were playing Carcassonne.
Yeah.
When I just kept being like, oh, interesting. Who's winning?
Okay. I think I'll... I don't want to pick Joyful because I think the picture is lame. It's like balloons with smiley faces on them. Nurturing is also lame. Mischievous. I'll go with Mischievous. That's silly.
Yeah.
How do you approach challenges or obstacles in your life? Oh my God. Ignore them, obviously. Taking time to meditate in nature and brainstorm solutions. That's two things. Embracing humor and creativity to navigate through them. Tackling them head on with determination and enthusiasm. Relying on the supporting guidance of family and loved ones. Thomas hosting a get-together. Probably going to pick that one.
Yeah, I mean, when I'm not avoiding my problems, I think probably relying on support and guidance of family members.
You guys deal with it.
Hey, can you fix this for me, please? Yeah,
I'm going to embrace humor and creativity to navigate through them. Because if you joke about it, you don't actually have to confront it. How do you typically approach planning for the future? Ignore it. We've been over this. Sense of creativity and the willingness to embrace the unexpected. And then it's a picture of two kids with water in their mouth, I would assume, doing a funny face.
I will never embrace the unexpected. I am risk averse.
Focus on sustainability, conservation, and making a difference. Determination, ambition, and I feel like all of these answers are the same.
Yeah, why are they, all these go-getter-ass answers? I am not ambitious, and I will never be ambitious.
I feel like...
Get the fuck out of here.
I'm starting to understand why this quiz maker only has 360 points.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, maybe you should get your numbers up if you're embracing everything with determination, ambition, and a passion for achieving goals and success. Doesn't seem like you've achieved them,
well,
so...
You can also cherish family traditions, creating lasting memories, and celebrating milestones. Okay. Couldn't be me.
I'm just going to pick the sense of humor one. I don't like any of these.
Wow. And you said you'd never embrace the unexpected, which is actually the number one thing you need to do on Survivor. Because what if somebody says, vote me out?
What am I going to focus on? Sustainability? Like, get out of here.
I'm going to focus on sustainability, conservation, and making a difference, actually. Okay. Thomas, let's do this next one. Read the next one to me.
Which movie do you enjoy watching the most? Hop, a movie we all know and love.
Yeah.
The Sandlot.
Yep.
Step Brothers.
Good movie.
And The Lorax.
I liked...
Picking The Lorax just because of the one weird... have you ever heard about the whole, like, Onceler thing? Mm-hmm. Where... Okay, so there was a Tumblr thing where there were fans that liked drawing this character that was in the movie called the Onceler, and apparently there's like two different versions of him in the movie, where one's like a cool version, and there were people that shipped the Onceler with the cool version of the Onceler.
Okay, I've seen this
and
guy
it was referred
around.
To as it was referred to as Oncest, no. And apparently some people were very angry about that people were doing this. It was like, there was like a huge war about it on Tumblr. This is basically the perfect story to tell of like, what was Tumblr like? It's like, this is exactly what Tumblr was like.
Yeah, man, I miss Tumblr. What a great time. I was thinking about...
Yeah, there was a lot of insane stuff that came out of that. Anyway, I'm picking Step Brothers.
I was thinking about getting back into Tumblr with this new doctor joining Doctor Who. Doctor Who, very similar to The Six in that, you know, they replace somebody every few years. But instead of every few years, it's every episode for The Six. Okay, what are we doing? You picked Step Brothers. I was going to pick Step Brothers because I thought you were picking The Lorax. I'm picking Step Brothers also because I don't want to get Earth Day.
I didn't watch The Sandlot as much as other kids did.
Never seen it.
I didn't have the same. I was more of an Angels in the Outfield guy as a kid.
I am an Earth Day enthusiast. An Earth Day enthusiast can be explained as someone who is optimistic, hopeful, and deeply passionate about environmental conservation. You are deeply committed to protecting the planet and promoting sustainability in all aspects of life. You have a sense of responsibility to preserve the Earth for future generations and are willing to take action to make a difference. What's yours, idiot?
I've never had this happen before. They didn't give me one.
Did you answer the last question?
Yeah, I did. It just nothing came up.
Huh. Refresh it.
April Fools, you are an April Fool's Day prankster. Fucking you thrive on humor, shit. Mischief, and playfulness.
I can't believe you did that. You really are embracing the unexpected
in humor.
You enjoy
the thrill of surprising people with unexpected antics and often have a knack for crafting elaborate and creative practical
something
jokes.
Got me.
People like you bring joy everywhere you go, making you beloved by many for your playful spirit and infectious laughter. Just don't take the jokes too far.
Decades, Thomas has told me. I hate pranks. I will never do pranks. And then what does he do for spring holiday that matches your personality? A fucking prank. You're right. Actually, this one did get it right.
The greatest prank of all.
Well, you know what? I know we were talking to shit about Jealous Hero 70 for their lack of diverse answers, but this one actually did get it right. I love the Earth, and Thomas loves pranks.
I do. I'm a real George Clooney with all the pranks I'm pulling.
Good stuff. Okay, Thomas, what's your Blue Sky or any other website you want to promote?
Follow me at tom.tom.bsky.social. If you're still on X, the platform formerly known as Twitter, you can also follow me at tom.tom there. And I think I deleted my Tumblr, so unfortunately I can't promote that one.
Got to get it back up. Because that was a great website back in like 2011 or so. We're also on YouTube, the only fun Survivor podcast. Maybe that's where you're listening to it now. Thank you so much. Our comments from last week included, somebody commented on our clip from us talking about how incredibly hot Venus Vafa is. And we all agree on that, right?
She's an attractive lady. I'm not going to pretend that she's not. Somebody, I just think it's like, anytime that anyone is like really laying it on thick there, I'm like, have you watched television before? Like there's so many attractive women that have been on television.
Yeah. What about Shiv? Have you ever watched Succession? Thomas loves Shiv. Shiv.
I do
Roy.
Like Shiv.
Thomas is a capitalist. So somebody commented about Venus Vafa, again, the hottest person of all time. Nah, she mid. What do you think of that?
Let's not go crazy here. Look, you know I love to hate on Venus, but she is not mid.
Maybe you need to go to Jupiter to get more stupider.
Also, I don't talk about women that way.
How do you talk about women, Thomas?
I say that they're not mid. I say that all women are not mid and they are queens.
All women are queens, yes. Every single one. Margaret Thatcher, queen shit. What can people comment on YouTube if they don't want to be rude to our favorite queen, Venus Vafa?
Yeah. She's not our favorite queen. All women's are queen.
All
women's are queen, the band Queen.
I like to call her Queeness.
Yeah, Queeness Vafa. But all women are queen, so she's not our favorite. All women are our favorite queen.
All women are our favorite
they're all queens.
Yeah. That can go on record.
Yeah, anyway, ha ha ha, very funny smiley face is what they can comment.
Yeah, please do. Our last poll asked, and this was from a couple weeks ago now, so it's expired, but is it the merge? What would you say as of 2 weeks ago? Is this the merge?
I would have said, who's to say?
Well, 14% of people also said, who can say? 14% said no. 71% of people said yes.
Hmm.
Well, so what can they, what poll can they vote on this week? I have it. Did you miss us?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, yes, of course. We have a few shows on Patreon as well. You can find them at patreon.com/justpodcast. Do you want to shout any of those out, Tom?
Let's shout out, what's one we haven't done in a while?
Man, there's so many. There's like 20 options.
There's
you can't
still
think of
a lot
one.
Of them. It's impossible to think of all of them. Wasn't there a John Cena one?
Yeah, Just Cena.
Just Cena, yeah.
Talk about anything Just Cena related. He was recently at the WrestleMania XL doing some shit. And the Oscars, did you see him get naked at the Oscars?
I did see it. I thought that was funny.
This is a little clip from Just Cena. You can check out more at justpodcast.patreon.com.
If you want to hear more about my opinion on how funny the thing at the Oscars was, pay up.
If you want to hear my opinion on how funny the thing was, you can subscribe to our movie podcast called... Do we have a movie podcast?
I don't think we do.
That's wild. We should probably have a movie podcast. We'll come up with that later.
Did you watch movie last night?
Did you watch movies last night? Perfect. We have a few shows on Patreon. We already talked about that. Do you want to thank the fans?
I would love to thank the listeners. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being patient, as there was nothing to listen to last week, but it was Jake's bachelor party, so fuck you.
Yeah, so we partied it up.
Just kidding. Just playing.
We're just kidding around. What could people write on Apple Reviews or any of the other review sites if they wanted to?
This is my favorite podcast. I like it better than all the other podcasts. I give it a big thumbs up.
And if you write that, we'll actually read it here on the podcast. Or if you want to reach out in any other way, you can do that and we'll read it here and we'll respond in kind. Until next week. I know we just talked about spring. Earth Day. What was yours? Oh, Prank Day. God.
Pranks.
Okay. I was really gunning for 420, but I guess that was yesterday. But tomorrow is 420 too. So celebrate that.
Have a dank summer.
Dankses. Playing this game last night where you land on a square and the square says cheers to, and you all cheers to whatever the person who landed. And our friend was wearing a t-shirt with a bison on it. And I said, cheers to bison, because, you know, I like the animal. And a friend said, oh, because of how we wiped out the bison to take out the Native Americans? I was like,
no,
bro. I was just trying to play a fun drinking game. And reference your t-shirt. You're the one wearing the t-shirt. So, we skipped her next turn.
You're in jail.
You are bringing down the vibes. We're trying to have fun here
and talk about animals we like.
Yeah. Real life wildlife shots.
Just like Tevin trying to talk about animals we like.
The downfall of Tevin. Oh man, I've got to update my. My fantasy team, because I put Tevin in the MVP spot at the merge, because everybody was high on Tevin.
I was so annoyed.
At least your man didn't leave.
Yeah, that's true.
What a wild couple of episodes, huh?
Yeah, it was. Remind me, who did I pick for the merge?
You didn't pick a person. You picked an entire film festival. International.
Oh, I picked TIFF. Okay, that's good that also they didn't go through with trying to get TIFF out of the... We're going to talk about the Six, but why would you want to be in the Six at this point? It seems like it's you have a better chance of getting eliminated if you're in it than if you're not in it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the only people who have been eliminated so far in the merge are people who were in the Six.
Yeah. Everyone keeps turning on each other in the Six. It seems like it's bad. You know, Drake was always talking about how it's rough in the Six, and it definitely does seem to be that way.
I said when the episode was airing, they should call it the 666 because it's so cursed.
Smarten up, Probst.